guys, I am actually kind of taking you off the beaten path.
Welcome, guys and gals, to another episode of Clintastic. Okay, guys and gals, instead of doing a typical road review, we're going to do a city. Now, the reason why I'm doing the city is because not only it means something because I live here, but at the same time, there are so many roads and trails here for you to hit, either on a motorcycle, on a car, whatever the case is. But I just wanted to give this a little bit more attention as such a beautiful place, not only to visit and to, you know, give a place of business, but at the same time to really enjoy the beauty of God's creation and really kind of see that Fallbrook in Southern California, located in San Diego, very northern part of it. It is such a quaint, beautiful place to visit. So guys and gals, what this is gonna be is a two-parter. Part one is gonna be kind of the northeast side of Fallbrook, and then taking you into Main Street and kind of seeing what it's all about. Then I'm gonna take you to part number two. It's gonna be mainly from Sleeping Indian right here, up here on the top of this hill, but I'm gonna take you down into some of the other funner rides and so forth. Do the loop, like I said at the very beginning. So guys and gals, I really hope you enjoy this, and have fun, enjoy the ride here. Okay, maybe you're, again, wondering why I'm starting the Fallbrook video from this perspective, that mobile or 76 gas station. But the reason why actually I'm starting it in that vicinity is quite simple, is, you know, Fallbrook isn't that very big, but in general, it actually is. You know, if you look at it kind of like a circle, that's the way that I'm taking this route. That's why I'm also doing it on an app, so you guys can see the loop that I do. As already stated in my opening, I'm not going to break down each road. That's not going to happen on this video. Again, the main purpose for this video is to share with you Fallbrook City. Not only is it a really cool place to visit, you know, and just know that, you know, you wanted to get you want to ride. Wow, I had my blinker on the whole time. But is to really experience simplicity of riding or just visiting a town that isn't very large. But again, in Southern California, a lot of it is the big stuff, you know, the big cities, but this is more rural, so that's why I wanted to go on it, and that's why, again, why this is such a fantastic place to go ride. Or I'm even going to you car people. You guys just want to cruise in your cars here. This is also another fantastic place. I'm actually quite bummed that there's not more car shows here or cruises here than there should be. There actually should be more rides here, but there's not. And maybe after this video, guys want to put things together, I totally encourage that, because this is a beautiful city. It needs more attention, and you know, it's just cities like this, I think, that need to be kept alive, but in the way of keeping it OG, you know, the OG style. See, another biker right there. There's actually a lot of bikers that do come up here, but I wanted to get it so people actually saw more of Fallbrook and what it has to offer. This is another little cool thing about Fallbrook. Right here, this little sign, it says, you know, Live Oak Fallbrook, but you see, notice it has Fallbrook with the avocado. You know, that's what Fallbrook is kind of known for, is agricultural and, you know, what it is.
But here, from this point right here, we're on Old Highway 395. We turn left here on Retchie, and we have 6 miles to get to downtown Fallbrook. Well, the reason, again, why I wanted to start this video and have it where it was is because that 6 miles, there's all sorts of just kickback fun riding to do. I mean, really, there is. So I wanted to, again, share with you guys why Fallbrook is such a not only beautiful place to visit, but such a beautiful ride. That's why we're doing this road. So I'm going to show you some of the little fun stuff that I cruise when I just want to get away from the house.
Shut up!
And get away from the kids and...
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Just go for a ride. This is actually a good video for my wife. I love her so much. She is my life. But sometimes we all have to get away for a second. And this is kind of the loop that I do a lot. So I'm going to share with you guys. And, you know, if you guys ever want to do it, it's a fantastic ride. But again, like I said, I'm not going to go through every single one. And I might even do a two-parter on this. Just because I don't want it to be a, you know, super long video. Agricultural. You're gonna see really quick all throughout this loop. This is how Fallbrook is actually. Is like this. See the roads up and down, little tides. That's what I was saying. I'm so surprised that there's not more rides out here. You know, but oh well. But you're gonna see some wineries. There's a brand new winery that opened up right here. Vineyard or whatever. And there's just different agricultural. This place used to be known for its avocados. Because again, water is so expensive, I think that's kind of why it kind of killed. Plus the fire that came in 2007, destroyed quite a bit of the farms out here. Here's a little fun little side note. I am definitely no historian, but a little fun fact. Fallbrook actually became into existence, and I want to say in 1865. See, Live Oak is actually, that's a Live Oak Park. This is a very, you know, historical park here. After it was established back in 1865 by the Retchie family. And then I think it became like officially called Fallbrook back in 1885. So, you know, this city, even though how small it is, see right there, welcome to Fallbrook. Even though how small it is, it's fantastic. All right, so here's a little side road that I always take. And again, it's just a fantastic, fun little side road that I encourage. This is a... If you've ever done Duluth Road, that by the way, if you see in one of my other videos, I do Duluth Part 1 and Part 2. I see a lot of people seeing Part 1, but not Part 2, and I don't understand that. But but definitely when you see Duluth, this is kind of reminds me of Part 2. Similar type of look, feel. You know, twisty, not super fast, you know, just kickback fun. But yeah, this is one of the little side roads. And as a disclaimer, as I say in all of my videos, we want to ride smart, right? Well, this is a residential area. Even though that it is a main road, this is residential. So I strongly suggest that you take it with caution when you're on it, because there could be a lot of cars that could pull out, okay? And that's where we need to ride smart and be smart. So obviously, if you know don't know the area, I would take your time and cruise and don't push it. That's all. That's all I'm saying. You know, and you also don't want to get the neighbors and the people here frustrated and really upset at you because there's a bunch of guys on bikes or hot rods or whatever going down their streets. You know, it's just gonna trigger people. Oh gosh, I always hit that bump. I've done this road like countless times and I always forget that bump. Anyways, a little fun little road, huh guys? So here, I'm going to be taking a hard left back onto old 395. This will take you, again, more town, more towards downtown Fallbrook. But again, this is just, I'm giving you guys the basic easy road here in Fallbrook that I say that people could do a loop on and really enjoy. And you wouldn't have to, you know, necessarily be a speed demon, but you could do something fun, right? Lots of military. Okay, so this is kind of what is normal. To see all the traffic, and I'm filming on a Saturday morning, I mean early. you're gonna get traffic, but you know, again guys and gals, why we ride is not necessarily to go fast and light our hair on fire. It's just to get out, get on a motorcycle, and enjoy and cruise.
I'm the king of the world!
Now obviously you don't want to get stuck behind the slowest poke you can get, but it's what's going to happen. And one of my videos, I say it's like biker 101. It truly is, guys and gals. It is. It's when you get on a road, especially when it's a beautifully beautiful road, you're going to get a lot more people because it attracts people. So now we're really getting more into downtown Fallbrook. As you can clearly see, guys and gals, it really is actually a very quaint kickback city that has a very peaceful, relaxing atmosphere. Another fun place. I mean, look at an old building right there. The really sad part about that I have to state with Fallbrook is it really would be, or could be better if, you know, there was more attention given to it. Meaning like there was more shows or more things put together, but there really isn't. In front of us, really quick guys and gals, is, you see it says S13 and then turn right. That is Deleuze. So Deleuze Road, that's where you start from in Fallbrook, right there. Oh, there is. Look, they shut down Main Street. So there is something going on. So I will have to go around it. Nice, dude. But look at that old movie theater, bike shop. That's pretty cool. as I already showed in my video, guys and gals, so far, as you can clearly see, it's just an old, quaint city. But yet, such a fantastic place to just come and cruise and enjoy. Look at all these just old shops. Fantastic places. You know, a lot of thrift stores, antique boutique, you know, places, nurseries are out here in Fallbrook, if that's also something you are into. There's a lot of that. Delicious foods here on Main Street. Different little places. I'm gonna be passing up here a barbecue place. I will try to give them a shout out, and again, no sponsor from them. It's just food from them a couple times. They make a really good smoked barbecue. So I have to give it credit where credit's due, and I will definitely put their address and their place where they are on this video here, and it's coming up right here on my right. Right here, Firehouse Que Brew. Give them a lot of cred. They make some really good smoked pork, chicken, and so forth. Just good food. So if you guys and gals are into that type of food and you want to enjoy a local brewery here in San Diego, they have that as well. As you guys kind of see, I'm kind of jumping around and about. There's an easier way to just make it a straight shot. So it's not like I'm saying, hey, this is the way to go only. But what I took you down is really what is known for Fallbrook. You know, the main streets, the old boutique stuff. And I'm going to take you down Main Mission, and I'm going to turn on a street that actually will take you to a place called Sleeping Indian. Or Sleeping Hill, or something like Sleeping Indian Hill, something of that nature. It's a beautiful lookout. I think that might be the end of part one when I get there, and then I'll show you a couple other roads here in Fallbrook and part two. Oop, bump. Fallbrook Historical Society. I've never actually gone. You know, really quick, I'm going to show you guys and gals this air park. Just for the fun of it. You know why? Because I can. You know why? Because I will. At Fallbrook, there is kind of like a mini airport. It's just its lookout. Pretty cool treat right there, guys and gals. Got to see an airplane land. That was cool. Now to Sleeping Indian. Nice. Oh, look at the puppers. Look at the puppers. Turn right on this street, Olive hill road. And basically we're gonna be on this for a little bit. Guys, I am actually kind of taking you off the beaten path, but the reason again why I'm doing it is to show you that even though that small city like Fallbrook has what it has, it also has just some gorgeous scenery that I'm just encouraging, you know, ones to see. And obviously, again, not to break the law or be stupid, but to just, you know, enjoy. Oh, that's a cool little metal statue. That's cool. This is Sleeping Indian Hill right here. This is it. We can't go to the very top of it. There's no real road to it. But that bump right there is technically part of it. If you look at it from a longer lens, it looks like somebody lying down. But this is part of the other hump. So when you look at it from a back perspective, it looks like they call it the Sleeping Indian. And we're gonna be heading up right up there so we can see the scenery of Fallbrook. And again, why it's so beautiful to be here. I'm gonna turn left right here. Now this is, again, guys, this is just called Indian Hill. This doesn't go anywhere. There's no outlet, there's no nothing. This is a technically, not a private road, but you know, I wanted to go up here so you guys could see how absolute gorgeous it is up here. And you know, again, just to show you, because I mean, look at the road. Hey guys and gals, I wanted to welcome you to part number two, but yet, hold on, you're still in number one. I know, I'm doing this a little different. I will start it back. Part two will start like this, but to conclude, guys and gals, I wanted to make sure that at least you knew that the end of part one, this is how you get to it. That's the only reason why I wanted to do it, so I'm leaving it as a cliffhanger.
You can do it, sir.
Hold her, Gabe. Hold her.
Gabe, please don't let me fall.
There's a section coming up that was right here that I'm just totally overshot for some reason. I don't know why. But this is Olive Hill Road, or I'll just put it on. But this is going to be another road. So I'm going to end it for you guys here, for those that, for part one, but part two is going to start right on this road. So hope you guys enjoy, and take care.
And guys and gals, again, thank you so much for watching these videos, and you know, I really appreciate, but if you can, please give me a like, give me a sub, all that fun stuff, and share it. And especially here, if you live in Fallbrook, share it with some of your friends. Maybe you've never even known that there was an airport here. I don't know. But whatever the case is, guys and gals, Hope you enjoy it. Again, as I always say, ride smart, be smart, don't do drugs, and hope you just enjoy. Take care, be safe, guys. Bye.